Same.
It is Chile and Ireland live right now here at the Homeless World Cup. It is our second match of the day here on Green Pitch, where our broadcast is focused. There are two pitches out to our right and out to our left as well. We'll continuously give you some updates as well for this, but this is a big time match here in the women's section between these two sides. And Brian, you were saying that Chile is one of the top of the pops teams to watch in this tournament on the women's side.
Yeah, I've enjoyed them. A lot of individual flair, really good off the ball movement and possession. They move teams around, which is hard to do, as you know, in this really, really confined space. So I've enjoyed them. And right now, the women's tournament's a lot simpler to follow than the men's. It's one group of 12 teams. They play a round robin. The top four move on for trophy contention, for World Cup contention, and the others play in those consolation brackets we've talked about. And so these are two of the top three teams in the tournament. Chile in second place, unbeaten, 7-0. Ireland in third place at 6-1. Mexico is also up there with them. So these are two title contenders we're about to watch.
And there is the Chilean goalkeeper. And that is Fenia in goal for Chile.
Chile in the red, Ireland in the green, but you probably guessed that.
Chantel Peirce, the goalkeeper for Ireland. And now Fenia asking her teammates to get up the field. Chile comfortable in possession. Into the pathway of Montes, who's in the corner.
She's really good, by the way.
And the shot comes in.
As you saw from her dribbling out from a situation where she was facing the own corner with the defender right on her back. She got out of it and set up a goal. So she's been brilliant in this tournament.
And that was Zavka with the first goal in this game. The goalkeeper, Peirce, got a hand to it, but I believe she needs a little bit of attention here as well, as she was shifting from the right side to the left. Zavka was unmarked by herself to have that strike. She's just getting a little bit of attention on her left shoulder.
The goalies fling themselves around in this format like crazy. I mean, it's diving, and we were talking with Dom yesterday, Dom Jakovic, the former Sacramento Republic goalkeeper, and you know, he was talking about just the almost like a hockey goalie, the splits and the way they have to kick out with their legs in this format to save shots, as opposed to, you know, you're using more of your hands in the 11-on-11 format. So a really punishingly physically punishing position, and we've seen, she's not the first goalkeeper we've seen sort of in some distress. But they are all insane warriors who will stop at nothing to be on the field, and so not surprisingly, she's back and ready to go.
Opening goal to Chile, and they lead by a goal to nil. That is McCormick in the corner, and Fenia back with it, gesturing with her right arm. Now Montes in the corner again.
She's gonna get out of it, watch. She's gonna get out of it.
Closely defended by Chloe Kenna, the captain.
Double teamed her this time, and maybe they're learning.
Well, she's unmarked as well on that right side. Leslie, and now Zavka, the goal scorer, into the feet of Montes. Montes' shot and the save. Nice one by Peirce. Corner ball for Chile.
We also want to give a shout out to the official merchandise partner of the Homeless World Cup, Streetball. Streetball clothing is designed by artist Juan Delastin Dossler. You can see
and
all
right,
the range on SoccerTalk.com.
I believe, let's see, is it going to be called back? No, it is a goal there for Chile. Ireland with their first attack in Chile's half. Again, it's always going to be three versus two. The shot comes in, Fenia makes a good save. And Ireland has to backtrack on Montes. That's Leslie Wither, Montese, lots of time.
The step overs, incredible.
McCormick, all the way back to Fenya. Chile in control here.
I think Montese should have to stay out and be the halftime show.
Just for step overs and other
tricks.
Technical.
Yeah, just go out and do tricks. Like Messi used to do when he was a kid at Newell's. You know, Messi was the halftime entertainment. Should be the same deal with here.
Chance on there for Chloe Kenna, and it's over the bar.
For the latter portions of the first half here, Chile in control, but not necessarily on the scoreboard. Still, you know, dominating the ball, dominating possession, they have the better chances. But as we've seen so often, one bounce, one fluke, one turnover, and Ireland gets on the board here, gets a little self-belief, and all of a sudden this is a game again. And again, Ireland's a team that's been beaten only once. So we're looking at two of the top three teams in the women's bracket so far. And we're going to see either Chile distance themselves or perhaps realize they've got an extra rival for the title.
That's Chloe Kenna in the corner. And now McCormick, the captain. Onwards here for Chile. And they are absolutely running riot on the counterattack. Zavka with another one. Zavka with the third for Chile. 2 minutes to go till halftime. And they're almost inviting Ireland to attack and almost over-attack because they know they can get them on the counter once they won back possession. That's incredible.
That's the, you know, it's interesting, right? Because theoretically playing with two defenders and having to leave your teammate in the attacking half is it supposed to be a disadvantage in defense. It's supposed to give the attacking team, you know, time on the ball, an open player, etc. But what an advantage it is when you win the ball back, right? You have an immediate counter to an attacking player who's not offside, because there is no offside in this version of the game. So position that player right. As long as she's moving off the ball and getting open in case her teammates win it, it's a weapon for the defending team as well.
Well, substitution for Ireland, Lauren Cunningham in the game. But they're sticking with McCormick. And the captain, Chloe Kenna. Here's Zavka, the goal scorer. She has a brace. Montese. And there's another one for Chile. They lead 4-0 now. And what a first half for Chile. And making the save again is Fenya. Cunningham had that shot just moments ago. Off the side by Kenna. Montese.
Little nutmeg there.
Just about 10 seconds to go until the halftime, but it has been all Chile in this game. There one more before half, potentially. Patty in the game on this left side. Patty with a goal for Chile. 5-0 now.
And that is halftime over on the yellow pitch. The score at the end of 7 minutes, Mexico 3 and Poland 1.
Chloe McKinney. Sorry, McEnany with that shot. And at halftime, it is Chile 5, Ireland 0.
So if you want a sense of Chile's pedigree here in the Women's Homeless World Cup, previous champion in 2014 is the home team in Santiago, and then a runner-up in 2013 in Poznan, 2015 in Amsterdam, and 2017 in Oslo. So a four-time finalist. This is a team that obviously has a good street soccer program and finds talented players, and they do it routinely. Here we are with the highlights.
On our monitors, Welcome back here to the Homeless World Cup, the 18th edition of the Homeless World Cup here. In our 20th year, and Chile leads Ireland by the scoreline of 5-0. If you're just following us, Chile was second in the group, and Ireland was third in the group. It was all one table on the women's division side, and it's been all Chile in this match. Ireland's had their fair share of chances, but Fania, the goalkeeper for Chile, has really played magnificently off of her line, and almost as a, basically, as we like to call it, a sweeper keeper almost, and so far off of her line that she's able to cut down the angles. Very intelligent goalkeeper. What happened? 5-1 now for Chile. Six goals to one. We are back here at the Homeless World Cup. This is the second half between these two teams in the women's section that have been absolutely outstanding. The third place Irish women versus Chile. And they lead 6-1. It has been all Chile, but can Ireland get back in this game? Yes. Yes, another goal for Ireland, and it's scored by Casey. Casey with the goal there. Terrific stuff. They've got to get a couple back-to-back goals here if they're going to have any chance. Casey, once again, the substitute. And now McCormick for McEnany. McCormick, Casey, save made by Fania. Fania makes it look easy. McCormick again, Casey, closed down. Back into the feet of Peña and, Fania, and Fania again, she takes her time and she often distributes the ball way up in the top right corner, the top left corner, waiting for one of her strikers. Typically that's Matisse who will make that run, but Patty made the run there instead. And Chile will have the ball firmly in the Irish defensive half. They have been magnificent to watch, Chile. Patty.
I wish I saw more teams doing that. That was a brilliant little overlapping run by the Chilean number eight, pulling Ireland away, and winds up being wide open for the return ball. The cross, you don't see a lot of that. You see usually typically see the point player and then the two wingers, and they kind of pass it back and forth and stay. But there you have that overlap with Chile, and Ireland had no answer for it. Again, really creative sort of outside the box tactics for this version of soccer, and I really enjoyed that goal.
Casey again for Ireland, and they're within four goals, but they don't have a ton of time to go in this game. Foul right there. Referee stops the game for just a moment. Gonna have to restart things in this 90 degree heat. As you had mentioned, Brian, this Chilean team has won a couple of titles, has won a couple of titles overall on the men's and the women's side, but their last title came when they hosted this tournament in 2014. And again, one of the top teams to watch, besides this Irish team and Mexico, who finished first in the group. Mexico, the current reigning champions, the cup holders, as we like to say, and they've won the last five titles, sandwiched between a Chile win, and Mexico had won two prior to that. So Mexico wins seven out of the last eight.
Yeah, like you said, Charles, Mexico, Chile, there is something about the tight confines and the cunning and the craft and the nuance, the ball control that, you know, Latin teams are famous for, right? I mean, it's not an accident that a lot of the people we consider the greatest players of all time, your Messis, your Maradonas, your Pelés, right? I mean, they come from a culture of street football. They come from a culture of doing creative, unexpected things with the ball, and this form of soccer lends itself to that kind of play. We've seen it from the Portuguese as well, who have obviously a lot of that sort of influence in them as well. So controlling the ball with both feet, with all sides of your foot, shoulder feints, dips, step overs, flicks, that's a really kind of stereotypically Latin way of playing, and we see that in the teams that dominate here at the Homeless World Cup.
And the final score here, it is Chile 7, Ireland 3, right here from the Homeless World Cup. And that is the final score here on our green pitch. Appreciate you tuning in. Coming up next, it'll be Switzerland versus Union Gospel Mission, a local team from the area. And they'll take a team photo.
They may meet again in the medal round.
And we'll be back with that match in just a little bit. Keep your browser locked here to the Homeless World Cup YouTube page.